it up. Step in, I'm moving out.
Yo, what's going on, everybody? It's your boy Nelly Nell from Hoopin' Live. Welcome back to another highly anticipated sneaker review. Today, we have the Adidas D.O.N Issue 2s. This is Donovan Mitchell's second signature shoe, and I'm really excited to talk about this shoe based on how much I like last year's model, the D.O.N Issue 1s. Once again, Adidas and Mitchell have put together a Marvel slash, you know, spider-like theme design, you know, hence Donovan Mitchell's nickname, Spider Mitchell. And also because Donovan Mitchell is a huge comic book fan. In my hands, I have the Signal Green Solar Red colorway. There's also a USA colorway that released for the 2020 Olympics, but unfortunately, that was postponed. I was contemplating on copying the USA colorway because those are super clean. But I ended up choosing the super bright, super flashy, you know, neon green colorway, the Signal Green slash Solar Red, even though the red looks more of an orange. These are crazy, man. These are super flashy. There's some other colorways coming out, such as the Crayola pack and some subtle team-like colorways. The D.O.N Issue 2s look a lot more sleek compared to the 1s. There are a lot of cool details on the shoes along with the continuation of the spider-like theme aspects. I really like how they place the three stripes right here. It kind of reminds me of the old, you know, Adidas Gil Zeros, but just on the other side. Here's a hot take for you guys. Will Donovan Mitchell have a better career than Gilbert Arenas? To me, I think Agent Zero is the better player. D. Mitch is still young, he still has a lot of room for improvement, and if he stays in the league long enough, I think he'll have a better career, you know, than Gilbert Arenas in the long run in terms of career-wise. It's hard to say whether or not he'll eventually be a better player than Gilbert Arenas because Agent Zero was nasty back in the day. And we're talking about career-wise and accolades, D. Mitch, you know, may have a better career, especially if, you know, he stays longer in the league. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below on y'all thoughts on Donovan Mitchell as a player. The D.O.N Issue 2 looks to take the features from its predecessor and refine it for improved performance. Let's see what it's all about. For traction, the D.O.N Issue 2 has a translucent rubber outsole with a web-like traction pattern showcasing a comic book style text underneath. I think the traction on the 2s have been very inconsistent depending on the type of surface you're playing on. There were some surfaces where the shoe was biting the floor really well, but there were also some where, you know, I was slipping and sliding. It does attract a lot of dust and dirt, especially if you're hooping outdoors. The grooves on these aren't very deep. When I wore these outdoors, they took a beating. And when I mean beating, durability-wise, I don't think these will last pretty long, especially if you're the type of hooper who likes to, you know, rock these shoes hardcore outdoors. The traction inconsistencies could possibly be due to the translucent outsole, so hopefully a solid rubber outsole will be better. For materials, it has a fused textile mesh that makes up the upper while also featuring synthetic overlays and paneling that provides a snug and flexible fit. The materials on the 2s have been improved compared to the 1s. The mesh feels a lot better, it's a lot more soft and a lot more flexible. The materials are pretty thick where it's pretty durable with the addition of reinforced areas of synthetic fuse and stitching in the toe. The tongue feels really, really nice. It's padded and gives you a plush and comfortable feel. Although the materials on the shoe feels a bit excessive, but if you're the type of person who likes to have, you know, a shoe that wraps around your foot really, really well, giving you like a cozy, snug, padded feel, these are it right here. But if you're looking for something more minimal and light, such as like a Kobe sneaker, these might be too bulky for you. For support and lockdown, the D.O.N Issue 2 has a mid-cut sock-like construction along with the rigid heel counter. There's also padded pillows in the heel that keeps your heel locked in place. Lastly, it has a cord lacing system giving you a locked-in and snug fit. The support on these were made for Donovan Mitchell's hard cuts and quick pull-up jumpers. He's very explosive in changing directions and stopping on a dime. And these right here really do get the job done in that aspect. The lacing system is really simple and does a really good job on locking down your foot, although the laces are a bit long, especially after you tie them. The base of the shoe is very wide where stability is really good where it's not wobbly. The midsole also comes up and above the side of the shoe, giving you really good lateral stability. For cushion, the D.O.N Issue 2 has a full-length, flexible bounce midsole cushioning setup that provides extreme responsiveness. Adidas slimmed down the bounce in the midsole, making the Issue 2s a lot less bulkier in comparison to the Issue 1s. In terms of feel for the cushion, it's very similar to last year's model where it's very bouncy and responsive. You're also getting decent core feel as well. The shoe has a curved shape and the midsole actually flexes with your foot with every step that you take, giving you pretty good heel-to-toe transition. This, I think, is an improvement from the D.O.N Issue 1s. With these, you're not gonna get that soft and plushy feeling that Boost has, but if you're the ones who like that more firm and responsive feel, the bounce on these are pretty good. As far as comfort and size fit goes, the D.O.N issue 2s run true to size. It's a little bit long in the front, but not enough where I have to go a half size down. But if you guys like that more snug-like fit, y'all can go a half size down. Y'all just gotta try it on and see how they feel. It's all a matter of preference. Comfort-wise, there weren't any issues in these really, in terms of, you know, maybe the shoe being a tad bulky, but, you know, not too much where it hinders the performance. As far as pricing goes, the D.O.N issue 2s retail for $100. Same price as last year's models, the D.O.N issue 1s. This is a very affordable hoop shoe. It comes with a good amount of tech while also being budget friendly. These were dated to release on July 15th, whether or not it was a worldwide release. I'm not sure if the States got these yet, but we are very lucky to have gotten these overseas. There's some sources that now say they're gonna be releasing on August 1st. So, I mean, they will be coming out soon, so stay tuned. And for my overall rating, I'm gonna give the Adidas D.O.N issue 2 a score of 4 out of 5. There are certain things that the D.O.N issue 2s do better than the D.O.N issue 1s, but that's also vice versa. The materials on these are solid, nothing too premium, but they do get the job done. The cushion feels similar to the D.O.N issue 1s, but with a slight improvement. I think the traction could be better. It's not super terrible, whereas the support and lockdown were really solid. And with the price point of $100, you're getting a pretty good performance hoop shoe in the D.O.N issue 2s. Nice beat, keep it up, thinking these women excite me, keep it up. Wishing y'all can pass me, run it up, step in, I'm moving at high speed, yeah.